the officer who shot Jacob Blake will not be criminally charged. Blake was paralyzed after being shot 7 times in the back in August by Kenosha officer Rustin Shesky, who was responding to a call at the scene.
Kenosha's district attorney made the announcement at a news conference late this afternoon, adding that none of the officers involved will be charged. Jennifer Cleese has you covered on what the DA says led to his decision. Jen?
Well, District Attorney Michael Gravely spent a lot of time going over the process of the investigation and the evidence this afternoon. He said ultimately he could not prove in court that Officer Rustin Shesky was not acting in self-defense when he shot Blake. The State Department of Justice handled the initial investigation of the shooting. In August, police were responding to a domestic call that Blake had taken the keys to a car and his child. The investigation showed Blake was armed with a knife when the officer shot him. The DA says none of the officers who responded will be charged, and neither will Jacob Blake. Meanwhile, he's reached out to the U.S. Attorney's Office to do a separate civil rights investigation of this incident.
Kenosha deserves a second legal opinion other than my own. I'm confident about the things I'm talking about today, but I believe that the healing process begins or is improved by an opportunity for members of the public to see other prosecuting agencies make decisions.
In the past hour, Jacob Blake's family and supporters spoke about their disappointment and anger over the decision, calling on the community to push for justice.
This is going to impact this city, this state, and the nation for many years to come. Unless the people rise up and do what they're supposed to do.
Blake's uncle called the decision a slap in the face, perpetuating systemic racism. The DA also asked Wisconsin's Attorney General to find an independent use of force expert to review this case separately. They brought in former Madison Police Chief Noble Ray.